Sarah Hug, Research Associate at the University of Colorado at Boulder and an evaluator for the BPC Alliance, CAHSI, the Computing Alliance of Hispanic Serving Institutions, will now share an evaluation case study. This example shows how evaluation helps to refine what is measurable and what kinds of data sets can be used to gather important project outcomes.
I wanted to walk through a short example from my work in evaluation, where we refined our evaluation plan to narrow in on specific measurable outcomes that fit within a short timeline. I work with the Computing Alliance for Hispanic Serving Institutions. This picture is of student, faculty, and industry partners at an event we held recently. As evaluators, we knew that it would be a long time before we could gather relevant data related to the overarching goal of the organization, to recruit, retain, and advance Hispanic students in computer science. These are the big picture goals of the organization and the vision the partner institutions share. However, measuring these things, particularly in the short term, is nearly impossible. For example, a freshman receive an intervention, we won't be able to tell if they were retained or advanced until at least 4 years later. We work with the organization to define more specific localized goals that fit within what we could change and measure more immediately. Because we work primarily with department chairs, we turn towards course level data within computer science. In these departments, the gatekeeper courses were stalling student progression towards graduation and in some cases leading students to change majors. CAHSI developed a course level intervention. Some of you may have heard of the initiative. It's called Peer-Led Team Learning, or PLTL. And implementing this led to greater student engagement through intense group work. The intention was to improve learning as well as advancement through the major. We addressed pedagogical practice in our evaluation and looked at institutional research data to compare completion rates before the intervention and after the intervention. So we looked at pedagogical practices and gatekeeper courses and how those influences student outcomes, including dropping the course, moving on to the next course, and the average grades that they were receiving in the courses. We also were interested in differences in outcomes based on student backgrounds or demographics. When working towards a goal, it's imperative to have results with punch. These are impact statements we were able to make following our study of PLTL using institutional research data that was already collected and was housed in the department. Prior to the implementation of PLTL and gatekeeper courses in the major, only 77% of students completed the course, while 87% of students completed the course after the advent of PLTL. Since we have a focus on Hispanic students, because of the project's goals to recruit these students, we highlight that Hispanic students showed a 6% increase in course completion. This was something that we could highlight with our funders, and also CAHSI could use internally to promote the work at the departmental level.